Welcome you all to this power electronics session. Already we completed first unit. In that we learned something about the power semiconductor devices. So now we are going to enter into the second unit. So in that, in this second unit, we are going to study about the phase controlled converters. Okay. So here the converter is nothing but the rectifier. Okay, in the second unit we will study this converter as a rectifier. Okay, about rectifier we saw already in the first unit. Okay, what is rectifier? Which converts the AC voltage into DC voltage. Okay, here comes an another term called phase controlled. Okay, phase controlled converter. Why it is named so? Okay, so what is phase controlled converter? So it is the one which converts an AC input voltage to a controllable DC output voltage. Okay, in a diode rectifier, power flows only from input to output and it cannot be controlled. The fluctuation of power will occur naturally with the fluctuation of supply voltage and load. In many applications, the power flow requires control. Okay, this control is required to compensate supply and load fluctuation. So for getting this controlled output, we are going to use thyristor. A thyristor converter can control the power flow by the phase control principle. What is phase control principle? Okay, so by using this principle, we will delay the firing angle of the gate. Okay, we will give the firing pulse to the gate terminal, so that firing pulse will be delayed for a particular period. So it is therefore possible to control the output average output voltage continuously from the positive maximum to the negative maximum by varying the position of the firing pulses. Thus, power can be made to flow from the AC to the DC side of the converter or vice versa, and it can work either as a rectifier or an inverter. Okay, so with this small introduction, we can enter into the second unit. First, we will see the applications of controlled rectifier. Okay, these rectifiers where we apply. Okay, so steel rolling mills, paper mills, printing presses and textile mills, these mills and all, they are driven by the DC motors. Okay, what is the input of DC motor? DC. But what we have is AC, so it should be converted into DC. So here comes the rectifier which converts, that is the controlled rectifier which converts the AC voltage into controlled DC. Okay, then in traction systems which are working on DC, electrochemical and electrometallurgical processes, magnet power supplies, portable hand tool drives, okay, there are many HVDC transmissions. Okay, so in these fields we use this controlled rectifier. Okay, next, what are the classifications of phase controlled rectifier? So basically we can classify this phase controlled rectifier into two types, that is single phase rectifier and three phase rectifier. Again, this single phase can be classified into single phase midpoint type rectifier and single phase bridge type rectifier. Again, this single phase bridge type rectifier is classified into two, that is single phase off controlled and single phase fully controlled. So this is also called as semi converter. Okay, single phase semi converter. Again, when we come to this three phase rectifier, it is also classified into three phase off wave and three phase full wave. Okay, again this three phase full wave rectifier is classified into three phase midpoint type and three phase bridge type. Again, this three phase bridge type, when it is classified, there is the three phase off controlled rectifier and three phase fully controlled rectifier. Here also it is this three phase off controlled rectifier is called three phase semi converter. Okay, here this is single phase semi converter and this is three phase semi converter. So before seeing all these rectifiers, we can see an important term called firing angle. Okay, what is firing angle? So it is defined as the angle between the zero crossing of the input voltage and the instant the thyristor is fired. Okay, what does it mean? See, take this waveform. Consider this is input voltage, that is Vs. Okay, now we are going to give the gate pulse. Okay, at the instant. At the instant alpha. So what is this firing angle? Okay, for this definition alone I have taken this. I have not given the output. Okay, to make you understand this firing angle, I have drawn this. Okay, this is gate current. So we give this gate current at this instant. Okay, then what is firing angle? So it is the angle between the zero crossing of the input voltage. Okay, this is the input voltage waveform. In that, the angle between this zero crossing. Okay, this is the zero crossing. From this zero crossing to the instant. Okay, and the instant where the thyristor is fired. At this instant, the thyristor is fired by this gate pulse. Okay, so this instant is called firing angle. Okay, this is called firing delay. Okay, firing delay. This angle is called firing angle. Okay, hope you understood. So this is denoted by the symbol alpha. Now we can see the rectifiers. Okay, different types of rectifiers. First type, that is single phase off wave controlled rectifier. It is also called as one pulse converter. Why it is called one pulse converter? Okay, so single phase off wave controlled rectifier is the one pulse converter. Okay, which produces only one pulse of load current during one cycle of source voltage. Okay, it produces only one pulse load current for complete one cycle supply voltage. Take this example. This is supply voltage, okay, positive off cycle and negative off cycle, both cycles together is called as one complete cycle. Okay, one cycle means one cycle consists of positive off cycle and a negative off cycle. This is the complete one cycle. Okay, so now we are going to give the gate pulse to the thyristor at this instant. This is alpha. Okay, this angle is alpha, as I said already. Okay, firing angle. So at this angle, I'm going to give this gate pulse. So at this time, what will happen? The thyristor will start its conduction and the output will appear across the load. This is the load current. Okay. So the output will appear across the load. This is the output current. Then we are not giving the negative gate signal for the and negative pulse. Okay. Then there will be no, because in the negative off cycle, the thyristor will be in the reverse biased condition. So it will not work. So there will be no output. Okay. So for this complete one cycle, we get only one pulse of output load current. Okay. That's why it is called as one pulse converter. Okay. We are not getting output in both positive and negative, but we are getting only in the positive off cycle, we get the output. Okay, that's why it is called as one pulse converter. Now we can see elaborately. So this is single phase off wave controlled rectifier with R load. Okay, because this is the load is resistance. Okay, resistive type of load we have added. So rectifier means it converts AC voltage into DC voltage. So input is AC. Okay, this AC voltage is given through a transformer. Okay, this is transformer. So the input Vs is equal to Vm sin omega t. Since the AC, what is the AC waveform? That is the sinusoidal waveform. Okay. So this is the AC waveform. Positive and negative of cycle. So first, okay, what is the equation of the sinusoidal waveform? Vs is equal to Vm sin omega t. Okay, so this is transformer. Through the transformer, we are going to give this inputs AC supply. Okay, this is step down transformer. Okay, it will convert this, it will step down this voltage, maybe 230 voltage. Okay, in single phase means 230 voltage. This 230 voltage is stepped down to the lower voltage, and this lower voltage is given to this thyristor. Okay, now what will happen when the positive half cycle and a negative half cycle? Now consider only first the positive half cycle enters inside. Okay, now the positive half cycle enters inside. So at that time, this is positive half cycle and this is anode. Okay, this is anode and this is cathode. So this thyristor is forward biased. When the positive half cycle enters inside, this thyristor is forward biased. But it will not conduct, okay, until the gate signal is applied. So now we are going to give this gate signal at the firing angle alpha. As I said already, okay, the output can be controlled by varying this firing angle. Okay, this is our control. This is in our control. Okay, so at this angle we are going to give the gate pulse to this thyristor. Now already it is in forward biased condition. Now the gate supply is given, okay, gate signal is given. So the thyristor will start its conduction and the output will appear across this load. Okay, for positive half cycle there will be output across this resistive load. What will happen during the negative half cycle? Okay, now the negative half cycle enters. Okay, so under this negative half cycle, this thyristor is reverse biased condition. Okay, the thyristor is in reverse biased condition. So the thyristor will not conduct and there is no output across this load. Okay, see here in this waveform only the output is during the positive half cycle, but during the negative half cycle there is no output. Okay, we can explain. Okay, in step by step I will explain you. So this is the input voltage which we give through the transformer. Okay, this input voltage, this input voltage waveform is this one. Okay, AC sinusoidal waveform. Okay, now during the positive half cycle, first positive half cycle enters inside, this thyristor is forward biased. We are going to give this gate signal. Okay, I am going to give this gate signal at this duration, that is alpha angle. At this alpha, I am going to give this gate pulse. Okay, then what will happen? The thyristor starts its conduction at this angle and what will be the output? The output follows the input. Okay, see here the same input waveform appears across this output. Okay, from this instant, okay, like this, the same thing appears across this load. This is load voltage. Okay, then so what till here the thyristor conducts, so there is output. Then for the negative half cycle, okay, now negative half cycle enters inside. At this time this thyristor is reverse biased. Okay, reverse biased, so there is no conduction of this thyristor, so there will be no output, so the output is zero. Okay, then again when the negative, now see here at the time at the angle 2 pi, okay, at this duration 2 pi, again this positive half cycle enters. Okay, again this positive half cycle enters, this thyristor is now forward biased, but it will not conduct. Okay, see here it will not conduct. Why? Because we are not giving the gate pulse. Okay, when we are going to give the gate pulse, we are going to give the gate pulse here, okay, at this instant, that is 2 pi plus alpha. Okay, since that is alpha, this firing angle is alpha, this is pi, this is 2 pi, then this is 2 pi plus alpha. At this 2 pi plus alpha, we are going to give this gate pulse. Okay, we are going to give this gate pulse. So at this duration, this thyristor will start its conduction and the old output, okay, appears across the load. So what is the output which follows the input? Okay, the same input will be appearing across the load. Okay, this is the output. Then what about the load current? Okay, since it is a resistive load, the voltage and current both will be in phase. See the waveform of the voltage and output, voltage and output current both are same. Okay, so keep it in your mind, for resistive load voltage and current, okay, waveform will be same. Okay, both are in phase. Okay, the amplitude may vary, but the phases are same. There is no phase difference between voltage and current. The same waveform we get. Okay, then what about this voltage across this thyristor, okay, thyristor 1. So when there is conduction of the thyristor, there will be no voltage drop across this thyristor. Okay, when this thyristor is conducting, there will be no voltage across it. But when it is in off position, okay, when it is not conducting, there will be a voltage drop across it. See here. So at this duration alpha to pi, the thyristor has its conduction. Okay, so at this time there will be no voltage drop, so zero. See here, the voltage drop across the thyristor is zero at this duration from alpha to pi, because it is in conduction mode. Okay, since when it is conducting, there will be no voltage across, voltage drop across the thyristor. But when it is in off condition, there will be voltage drop. See here, here there is no conduction of the SCR. Okay, that's why the output was zero. So at this duration, there will be a voltage drop. Okay, the same voltage will be, voltage drop will appear across the thyristor. So here also, in during the negative off cycle, there is no conduction of the thyristor. So at this duration, there will be a voltage drop across the thyristor. So this duration also, there is no conduction of thyristor. So there is voltage drop across it. Okay, hope you understood. So this is the waveform and explanation about this single phase of wave controlled rectifier with R load. Then we can see the performance parameter for this single phase of wave controlled rectifier. So the output voltage, what we get is DC output. Okay, the input is AC, what we get in the output side is DC. Okay, that's why, so this is V naught DC, okay, average output voltage, which is equal to 1 by 2 pi integral alpha to pi Vm sin omega t d omega t. So why we have written here 2 pi? See here, so one complete cycle is from 0 to 2 pi. Okay, so 2 pi, one complete cycle is, complete cycle occupies 2 pi angle. Okay, that's why we have written here 1 by 2 pi. What is alpha to pi? So here we are going to find the output voltage. Okay, output voltage, where we get output voltage? Okay, alpha to pi we get the output. Okay, other duration output is zero. So alpha to pi only we get the output voltage. So I'll take the limit alpha to pi. Then why this Vm sin omega t? Okay, we are writing the output equation. Then why this Vm sin omega t? See here, this is input equation Vm sin omega t. Why we write this for output? See here, the output voltage, okay, so the output follows the input. So input is here Vm sin omega t, the same input appears across this output, across this load, that is output voltage. Okay, that's why we write this equation Vm sin omega t, okay, into d omega t. Since we integrate, this is integral term, d omega t. So next step is, we can take this Vm outside. So Vm by 2 pi, if you integrate this term sin omega t, what we will get is minus cos omega t. If you integrate this sin omega t, you will get minus cos omega t. Then the limit is alpha to pi. Okay, then Vm by 2 pi minus cos, instead of this omega t, apply upper limit minus lower limit. So minus cos pi minus of, okay, before seeing this step, please see this step, minus cos pi minus of minus cos alpha, upper limit minus lower limit. Okay, then then this step will come. Okay, so before this step, okay, not this one. So minus cos phi, minus cos pi, minus into minus plus cos alpha. Okay, so we get this term. Again, Vm by 2 pi minus, what is the value of this cos pi? Minus 1. So minus of minus 1 plus cos alpha. So Vm by 2 pi minus into minus plus, so plus 1 plus cos alpha. So this is the average DC output voltage of the single phase of wave controlled rectifier. So remember this equation, it will be used for solving the problems also. So V naught DC average output voltage is equal to Vm by 2 pi into 1 plus cos alpha. Okay, this I have written again. Oh, so when we get maximum output voltage V naught occurs at alpha is equal to 0 degree. Okay, if you put this alpha, if you make this alpha 0, then what will happen? Cos 0 is equal to 1. Okay, cos 0. So 1 plus 1, 2. So Vm by 2 pi into 1 plus 1. So this is 2. Then this 2 and this 2 will get cancelled. So the result is V naught m. Maximum output voltage is equal to Vm by pi. Okay, so when the angle is alpha is 0, you will get this maximum output voltage. Then second one, average load current. Okay, current is equal to output, current is equal to voltage by R, that is resistance. I is equal to V by R. So output current is equal to output voltage by resistance. What is output voltage? Already we have obtained here. This is the output voltage Vm by 2 pi into 1 plus cos alpha. So Vm by 2 pi into 1 plus cos alpha divided by R. So we have written this R here. Okay, this is I naught is equal to V naught by R. This is average load current. Next one is RMS value of the output voltage. So already we saw about the average DC voltage. Now we are going to see the RMS value of the output voltage. So V naught RMS equal to 1 by 2 pi alpha to pi Vm square. So this and all why we put already I told. Okay, then Vm square sin square omega t. Okay, whole power 1 by 2, otherwise whole root of. Okay, because this is root mean square value. Okay, take the same equation root. Okay, so this equation can also be written like this. Okay, within the root you can write 1 by 2 pi integral alpha to pi Vm square sin square omega t. Okay, like this also we can write. Okay, so instead of putting this root, I have used 1 by whole power 1 by 2. Okay, both are same. So V naught RMS equal to 1 by 2 pi alpha 2 pi Vm square. Sorry, I have repeated the same step. Okay, just ignore it. So V naught RMS is equal to, take this V, since it is in the root, if you take this Vm square out of the root, we will get Vm. Okay, so we have taken this Vm square out of the root. So Vm into 1 by 2 pi alpha 2 pi sin square omega t d omega t. Okay, now we can write. So Vm is outside, 1 by 2 pi alpha 2 pi this sin square omega t term. Okay, this term it is in the formula. Okay, this is the formula, that is sin square omega t is equal to 1 minus cos 2 omega t by 2. Okay, so this is formula. Okay, this is formula, sin square omega t is equal to 1 minus cos 2 omega t by 2 into d omega t. Okay, whole power 1 by 2. Next step, so for continuation, the same step I have used here also. So Vm into 1 by, since this here a number 2 is here, so take it outside. Okay, if you come this side, what will happen? 4, 1 by 4 pi. Okay, 1 by 4 pi. Then here if you integrate this 1 into d omega t, okay. If you integrate this d omega t, 1 into d omega t, d omega t. If you integrate this d omega t, you will get omega t minus cos 2 omega t. Okay, minus, if you integrate this cos 2 omega t, we will get sin 2 omega t. Okay, again integrate this 2 omega t, you will get by 2. Okay, so sin 2 omega t by 2. The limit is alpha to pi. Okay, whole power 1 by 2. So next step, Vm into 1 by 4 pi. Now apply upper limit minus lower limit. Okay, instead of this omega t, upper limit is pi. Okay, pi minus alpha. Pi minus alpha. Okay, for this term you have applied. Then minus. Okay, minus. Then for this term you apply the limits. Sin 2 pi. Instead of this omega t, sin 2 pi minus sin 2 alpha. Okay, upper limit minus lower limit divided by 2. Okay, then all other terms. So you have to put the brace carefully. Okay, so this brace is for this term, and this brace is for this term, and this brace is for the whole term. Okay, so next step, Vm, we can take this 4 pi also outside. If you take it outside, if you take 4 out of the root, it will be 2, okay, because 2 square is equal to 4. So if you take 4 outside the root, you will get 2. Then pi, root pi, okay, we can write, we cannot take outside the root, okay. So write within the root, so Vm by 2 root pi, okay, take separately. Then other terms, pi minus alpha plus, okay, 1 by 2, why we get here this sine 2 pi term will become 0, okay. Then minus into minus plus, so plus sine 2 alpha by 2. So instead of writing sine 2 alpha by 2, I have written 1 by 2 sine 2 alpha, okay, whole power 1 by 2. This is the value of RMS value of the output voltage. Then what about the current, RMS value of the current? So I naught is equal to RMS value of the voltage by resistance. There already we saw the load current I naught is equal to for average voltage V naught, average voltage by resistance we wrote. Here this is RMS value of current, so I naught is equal to V naught RMS by R. Okay, then DC load power, that is PDC, is equal to IDC square R. So PDC is equal to, what is IDC? IDC is nothing but the previous one what we saw, okay. So this is the DC current, that is Vm by 2 pi R into 1 plus cos alpha. Now use here. So Vm by 2 pi R into 1 plus cos alpha. Okay, so IDC is equal to Vm by 2 pi R into 1 plus cos alpha. Okay, take the square term. This is IC, IDC value. Take the square term. What will happen then? Vm square, okay, 2 pi square. Okay, 2 pi square, what will become 2 pi, 2 square, pi square, r square. So 2 becomes 4, 4 pi square, okay, into r, pi square r into 1 plus cos alpha the whole square. Okay, so this, here it will be 4 pi r square. Already there is r, so 1 r will get cancelled, that's why there is balance 1 r. Okay, so Vm square by 4 pi square r into 1 plus cos alpha whole square. Then power delivered to resistive load, okay, PAC, which is equal to RMS load voltage into RMS load current, that is V naught RMS into I naught RMS. Then input volt ampere rating, input VA is equal to RMS value of source voltage into total RMS line current, that is VS into IS. Then input power factor, okay, in what is input power factor? Power delivered to the load by input VA. So V naught RMS, I naught RMS divided by VS IS, where this IS is equal to I naught RMS, that is RMS value of output current. Okay, so this, the same term can be written as V naught RMS, I naught RMS by VS into IS can be written as I naught RMS. So we can cancel this I naught RMS and I naught RMS. So the rest of the term is V naught RMS divided by VS. Okay, this is the input power factor. Then what about rectification efficiency? So efficiency means always output by input. Here in this rectifier, the output is DC power, input is AC power. So output power is DC power divided by AC power. This is rectification efficiency. What about the form factor? Okay, RMS value of the output voltage divided by DC value of the output voltage. So V naught RMS by V naught DC. This is the form factor. Then what about ripple factor, which is equal to root of V naught RMS by VDC, that is RMS value of output voltage by DC value value of the voltage, the whole square minus 1. That is, this term is, that is V naught RMS by VD is nothing but form factor. So instead of this term, we can write form factor F of square, okay, F of the whole square, F of square minus 1. This is the ripple factor. Then transformer utilization factor, T, which is equal to PDC is divided by VS IS, DC power divided by the source voltage into current. So next one is peak inverse voltage of the thyristor, that is PIV, is which is equal to Vm. So Vm is the maximum voltage. This maximum voltage is called as peak inverse voltage of the thyristor. Okay, so this is about the single phase half wave controlled rectifier. Thank you.